What is it called?
Sweetness.
Arey, it's on top of dahi also. It's on top of milk also. Arey.
Curd.
No, not curd.
Dahi.
On top of that, crust. On top of milk. Crust. No, on top of milk.
Malai.
Yes.
Hello everybody. Welcome back to Menu Please Lockdown Edition. Now here's the thing guys. Usually on this show, we'll have one dish or we'll have one cuisine, but not today. You see, today there are no restrictions. In this episode, we're doing Menu Please Cheat Day. And I'm eating everything that my mind, my tummy, and my heart desire. And while I do that, I'm going to have a conversation with one of India's most promising young talents. You've seen her in Dhadak, you've seen her in Netflix's Ghost Stories, and very soon you're going to see her in Netflix's biopic about Gunjan Saxena. Ladies and gentlemen, my cheat day chat chum is Janhvi Kapoor.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm extremely hungry.
Yeah, I have a neer dosa over here and it's become a papad. So I don't want to take too much of your time before we start eating. Let's open this challenge by introducing our audience to what we're going to eat. I'll go first. In Kinney's corner, weighing in at about 2000 calories, we've got a butter chicken roll. We've got a biryani, a nice thick sweet lassi, prawn gyros, and some malai rabdi. Alright, and in Janhvi's corner, weighing in at how many calories do you think you're going to eat today?
I don't know. I don't think it's wise to count. It might depress me.
5 million calories. We have
paneer makhani, vegetable stew, red rice. I have red rice biryani, cheese dosa, okay, sweet potato paratha, jalebi, gulab jamun, and then I have kalakand.
Your spread looks delicious. So what do you want to eat first?
I want to have my paratha first.
Okay, perfect. In that case, I shall open with my butter chicken roll. I used to eat this a lot when I first moved to Bombay. It's perfect in the rain.
This is actually what I had for dinner last night also. It's yum. And the way he makes parathas at home, it's super crispy.
Now, I know that both you and your character, Gunjan Saxena in the film, you're both Punjabis and Punjabis really care about their food.
You know, I feel like I'm more South Indian than Punjabi.
Oh.
And my father has this thing, he's a proper Punjabi. Whenever we travel, Dad has this habit, he doesn't trust the food choices or the food options that we have over there. So we travel with, you know, a packet of green chilies because he feels like chilies outside of India aren't spicy. God.
In lockdown, you haven't been able to go out and shoot on set and go on location and do your thing. So as an actor, what have you been doing at home to improve your craft?
We're watching movies, discussing them with my father. I'm making him watch all of these films that I don't think he would have ever been inclined to watch otherwise. Like
High School
Little Women.
Oh, okay.
You were way off. I said Little Women and you said High School Musical. Yeah, that's how I'm learning about cinema. And improving my craft in the lockdown and watching High School.
Remember guys, we're all in this together. A great quote from High School Musical. I was listening to this podcast that you did with the BBC and you mentioned that you make sure to try and watch one movie a day.
Yeah.
Can you name the top three performances from an actor that, you know, really inspired you? You aspire to be that good someday?
Definitely Jenna Rollins in A Woman Under the Influence, Daniel Day-Lewis in My Left Foot. I think Dilip Saab in every single thing that he's done. I love Madhubala in Mughal-e-Azam. Oh, and Vahida Ji in Khamoshi. Like, I recently rewatched The Terminal.
Oh my god, me too. On Netflix.
On Netflix. And I was so excited when it came on Netflix because I love Tom Hanks.
My favorite thing about Gunjan Saxena, the film, is the scenes where you interacted with Pankaj sir, because your chemistry made that whole daughter-father dynamic so fun to watch, so endearing. Working with an actor like him, did you learn a lot?
He's just such an iconic person, I think, to be around.
Yeah.
I actually learned a lot about food also. He introduced me to so many amazing dishes in Lucknow when we were shooting. He has obsessed fans all over India and every day people would keep sending him food. So yeah, learned a lot about food. Learned even more about being patient and relaxed in front of the camera.
I feel like watching the film, a lot of young girls are going to feel inspired and they're going to aspire to be like Gunjan Saxena. But I kind of hope that a lot of young boys and even grown men aspire to be like
Pankaj's character. So, yeah.
I feel it's a very progressive and refreshing take on like a father figure. Did you get stuck? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm sorry I was making funny faces throughout. I couldn't hear anything.
Yeah, I was asking the question and you got paused like this. You just went like... I was like, okay, I guess I'll move on then.
No, that's not... Now I'm starting with my biryani.
Okay, then even I'll start with my biryani.
I feel like my red rice biryani is quite infamous. Every time I go for shoots and stuff, they always ask for it.
What is it about having red rice in the biryani versus basmati?
I just enjoy the texture.
And how... Okay, please don't die on this show. Did you just dump all those airport chilies into your food today?
I think he did.
That's hilarious.
I'm having my dosa and avial now.
Alright, I'm gonna switch to, I'm gonna eat my papad and ghee roast.
So like in the canteen or in the mess, they usually have dal, rice, sabzi. Yeah, it's quite, it's basic food only. There's no like super special food that they use so that they can fly in the air. But
They probably don't have cheat days like this in the Air Force. I hope not.
If I was eating this and going in a chopper, I'd probably fall asleep.
That would be a different movie for sure.
But I did that. You know, I had a really heavy
meal. You slept in a chopper?
No, I couldn't sleep, obviously, because like there was a camera on me. But it was, we were shooting in Georgia and I had this amazing... cheese pizza. I had like a 1 hour break and they're like, okay, no, something's cleared up, we need you right now. And I'm like walking in slow motion towards the chopper with this stone hanging and they're making me sit, and it's all of those like maneuvering moves. I don't know if you remember.
I did throw up
after that. I was like, I can't.
I saw this Netflix feature where Gunjan ma'am's on set and she's standing there and she's like, I just lived my life. I didn't know it was exciting until these guys wanted to make a movie about it, which I thought was really solidified her as a person.
Yeah.
So when you met her, did you find any similarities between you and her character at that age?
I think the only similarity was in terms of outlook. I think she has a very purist approach to her work. Like, according to her, if you work hard, you get where you have to get, and it really comes down to your work. And I think I'm a firm believer in that. I feel like there can be noise and chatter around it and you can do a million things, but like really it comes down to your work.
How did you put yourself in the shoes of a real life person?
You know, I'm so lucky that I had her with me. She was there every time we had any doubts. Shari, the director of our film, actually says it was like an open book exam.
Was it like you would do a scene and you try something different and then everybody on set just turns and looks at Gunjan ma'am and she's like... No, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. And then, all right, cool. We can move on, guys.
Yeah, there were definitely like moments where there was a lot of technical lingo being used, or where there was a lot of like technical body language. We would look at her kind of for approval.
What was it like behind the scenes when you were interacting with your cast? You guys seemed like a tight knit. Genuinely, you seemed like a family.
The weather was so hot; it was averaging at about 48 to 50 degrees in Lucknow. So we'd all have lassis come on to set. So like we were all just gorging on lassis and we all had like so much sunscreen on. We were all looking like Casper the Ghost walking around set with lassis.
That's hilarious. Oh my god. I'm just going to try and embody your spirit during shoot and drink my lassi now. I wanted to ask you, it's your last day on earth. You have 3 meals. What do you eat for breakfast, lunch, dinner?
I have thought about this more than I should. I definitely think cheesecake would be one of it.
For breakfast?
Yeah, I mean, what the hell, the world's ending.
Flavor?
I think the normal New York baked cheesecake, and I know which one, the one from Eileen's Bakery in New York.
Ooh, yum.
Second, at the Chennai Taj Coromandel Hotel.
Okay.
They used to make this tiramisu for me, which they don't make at the hotel anymore. I think the chefs changed, but it was like... Oh, I can't even think about it without crying. I was a kid, but I can still taste it. Now I need something savory and spicy, and I think it would either be galotti kebabs, and my vegetarian backup would be dal makhni and cheese naan.
Dude, it genuinely feels like you have been asked this question every day your whole life. You answered it with so much detail.
So much clarity.
I really like the way you describe food. So can you tell me, what is the key to a perfect lassi as I take a sip?
Sweet, maybe a little tangy when you get past the initial, what is it called? I have it all the time. What is it called?
Sweetness?
No, the thing at the top that you have to have. Arey, it's on top of dahi also. It's on top of milk also. Arey.
Curd?
No, not curd.
Dahi.
On top of that.
Crust.
On top of milk.
Crust.
No, on top of milk.
Malai. Malai.
Yes.
Oh my god, we couldn't think of malai, guys. Subscribe. We had malai rabdi in front of us.
So yeah, so it needs to have a lot of that, like a lot of it. And you need to have a little bit of cardamom, a little bit of cinnamon. You need to have it cold in that matka glass. So when you hold it, you really feel like you're, you know, having the full experience.
Oh my god. Guys, can we cut to a clip of my lassi crying listening to that explanation? This is such a sad lassi compared to that. It's okay, lassi. It's fine. You taste good. Anyways, let's move on to the dessert. Is that homemade?
Yeah.
How does it differ from like other jalebis?
I've actually never had a jalebi before in my life.
What?
You must have had this. Mysore pak.
Oh my god, yeah. Oh, it's so good.
Mysore pak, palkova. Palkova is my favorite. The South Indian version of it is a little different. Every time I go to Tirupati, I get like my stash of palkova.
Oh,
it's
my
too
god.
Good. So when I climb up Tirupati, I know that on top my reward is that there's palkova waiting for me. So I'm like on a mission when I'm climbing.
Wait, what are your favorite places to visit in South India?
I love going to Tirupati. I love going to Tirupati. I love climbing up. I love the vibe. I love just spending time there. I love Chennai, of course, because, you know, my maternal house is over there.
Do you have any like fun memories from Chennai?
There are too many fun memories. So we spent like months on end over there. And Mama would put like mogras all over the house. So like the smell of mogras when you wake up, and then she'd play like Rehman music.
Roja
and all of that stuff. So waking up to that music, those scents, and then in the kitchen they're making rasam, rice, dosa, and like me and my cousins, we'd pretend to be interior decorators, and we'd pretend that we're going shopping for like artifacts and paintings. And she's the client, and I'm the decorator, and Papa had his office, so I'd be sitting with my notepad. I'm like, so this is the plan that I've made for your house, and we can go on to the shop in the next one, the next. The shop was actually like the living room.
Dude, you had some proper business acumen at a child's. I was playing Kalla Police, you were doing interior design. That's crazy. That being said, thank you so much for joining us on this episode, Janvi. It was such a pleasure talking to you about the film. I really enjoyed it. It's so inspiring and endearing at the same time. And you guys did a great job.
Thanks.
I'm going to go put all of this food in the fridge. And hopefully, I see you next time. And I'm excited to see where your film career grows. I know you're going to work hard and do your best.
Thank you so much. This was so much fun.
I struggled throughout this interview to not call you Gunju. So that is a good testament of how you acted.
There have been so many, you know, I've done so many interviews and almost all of my, so Gunjan, and I'm like, what? I'm not like...